G'day, it's George Truman, and welcome to What the Wednesday. Today I'm here at Pilliga at a field day that's been hosted by the Merimborough and Yarrie Lake Landcare Group. This has been funded through the National Landcare Program and Northwest Local Land Services. The field day was about looking at what native grasses are in the paddock, especially after the recent rain and the great season we've had. We've seen a diversity of grasses, and many landholders have been asking me what's in their paddock and how palatable and nutritional is it. So today we've got together, we've had 35 landholders, we've had some staff from LLS come along, and we've had a really good look around. And I'm just here with Jaffa from the Yarrie Lake Landcare Group, a landholder in the area. Just like to hear, what have you found about the day? What have been some of the highlights, and what's been your interest in coming along today?
As a landholder, I've only got a small holding, but learning about the native grasses, how they become palatable, how to keep them palatable, and how to get them, to encourage them onto their land, and just generally getting an idea of what species are out there.
That's right, and it's quite amazing. Just in this small area where we're standing, I walked out this morning, and I probably saw about, you know, 30 or 40 different grasses, and that was one of the things that Kate highlighted, was when you look across the paddock, it looks like, you know, you've got a lot of spear grass and love grass and that, but once you actually look down, it's quite a diversity, and some of those species were quite palatable.
Yes, it's quite good to sort of sit there and really look at the grasses. As you were saying, looking at bird's eye view down, straight down, to seeing what variability there is in there and how much, it's not just one species, it's lots of different little species altogether.
And Mitch's session, when he talked about the different flower heads and sort of when you do see a grass, what are its characteristics and then where to look in the book, how useful do you see that as being?
Extremely useful, because that's, you know, how do we identify them when we go home? It's all great having someone here going, yes, this is love grass, that is kangaroo grass, but it's when you're home with the book going, oh, now what did he say? Oh, that's right, this grass was with this flower head, that was that one, that's what I've got to look for now. It was really fantastic.
Just seeing that the diversity, and also the idea was for people to bring in a grass from their own farm, and that was really good. We were able to identify that, and I saw we had the tables laid out with a lot of the grasses that we'd found labelled, and I could see them saying, oh yes, that's what that is. So I think that was a great idea, was to have them here. So and then we heard from Roger McDowell about the paddock. Did you find that sort of interesting as well?
Yes, I mean, he's got some, you know, has over many years has developed this into quite a nice sustainable landscape. It's been fantastic to sort of see that long-term visage happening.
Mm. No, well done. No, thanks, thanks, Jaffa. And we'll let you get back to mingling, because one of the important parts of these days is networking and meeting people and sharing knowledge. So well done and a great day.
Thank you very much.
Very good. So that's it for What the Wednesday. So hopefully you will enjoy that segment on the Native Grass ID Day, and we look forward to seeing you in the paddock next week.